Ladies and gentlemen, our opening ceremony is about to begin. Please stay in the Zoom and make sure to turn your camera on. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. Wabihi nasta'inu ala umurid dunya waddin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala asrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in amma ba'du. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Today, on the 8th of March 2024, the fourth day for Library and Information Science Study Program of YARSI University's International Short Course 2024, which entitled Digital Transformation, Interplay of Technology, Culture, and the Role of Librarianship in the Global Era. This event has been organized to help students navigate themselves through digital transformations, the interplay of technology, culture, and the role of librarianship in the global era.
First of all, let us express our gratitude to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala for the blessing which allow us to participate at study event in great condition. We also convey our sincere prayer and greeting to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who intercession we await Yaumul Qiyamah later. Amin ya Rabbal Alamin.
Excellency, the founder of YARSI Foundation, Professor Dr. Jurnalis Uddin PAK. Excellency, the rector of YARSI University, Professor Dr. Fasli Jalal PhD. Excellency, the Dean of Faculty of Information Technology YARSI University, Dr. Ummi Azizah Rahmawati S.Com M.Com. Excellency, the Head of Library and Information Science Study Program, Indah Kurnianingsih SIP MP, and the distinguished for all the participants of the short course. Before we started, let us introduce ourselves. My name is Baik Sabrina Zahra, and this is my partner.
I'm Kaizana Mira. Ladies and gentlemen, in this morning, we will have the several agendas as follow. First, the opening of YARSI University Summer School 2024. Second, reading of moderator's curriculum vitae. Third, the presentation of the first topic regarding exploring the power of semantic web, enhancing information discovery and knowledge integration, which will be presented by our great speaker, Professor Roslina Onman. Third, the discussion and documentation session. And the last, closing the international short course event in series.
Before we started, we remind you to stay in the Zoom until the end of the session due to some announcement from academic course team about academic completion. Now, allow us to read the curriculum vitae of our moderator today, Mr. Agus Rifai, PhD. He has a PhD degree in Library and Information Science. His teaching focus is on Library and Information Science, or LIS, Foundations and Research, Indexing and Abstracting, Information Resources and Service for Islamic Studies. He also a member of Association of Indonesian Library and Information Science Higher Education Institutions, Indonesian Scholars of Library and Information Science Association, and Indonesia Library Association. Now let's listen to the reading of our speaker's CV. So to our moderator, Mr. Agus Rifai, please go ahead.
Okay, thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ladies and gentlemen, and distinguished guests, and special for participant. Firstly, I would like to greet our speaker today. Assalamualaikum, Prof. Roslina.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Dr. Agus.
How are you, Prof?
Okay, alhamdulillah.
Sihat.
Ya, sihat.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, to our esteemed speaker and participant, today we have a special session, yeah, and the last session for international online short course. The topic today is exploring the power semantic web, enhancing the discovery of information and knowledge integration. I think the topic is very, very interesting topic, because discovery information is the current issue, especially in library information and information science. And to explore the issue on information discovery today, there is the expert, Prof. Roslina from International Islamic University Malaysia, to explore more, about information discovery and knowledge integration through exploring the power of semantic web. I think so. As we know that in this digital era, the internet has become the primary source of information that people use to search or to find information that they need. We are accustomed to searching information through library catalog or a search engine. That I think there are many barriers or many weaknesses of the tool, of that tools. For example, in traditional library catalog, for example, maybe we search particular books, and we find only the list of title, but right now with the semantic web, a library catalog can offer more than we expected or we said. And how the semantic web works today, Prof. Roslina will explore and explain to us, and we can learn more, because I have read the presentation from material from Prof. Roslina. She will explain and show us the case, how semantic web used for information searching. Okay, all participants, maybe in this course we will learn about what is semantic web and how does it works, and secondly, maybe we can also learn how the semantic web change the way we search for information. And I think we will learn more about information behavior, and the changing of we search for information through the semantic web. But before Prof. Roslina present his presentation, her presentation, I would like to remind you that we have two sessions. The first session is presentation from the speaker, and the second session is a question and answer. I would like to give you chance to ask to speaker. You can raise your hand, or you can write your question through the chat, Zoom chat, and I will read, and our speaker will read the question. Okay, we have 2 hours, yeah. We have two hours, yeah, for this session, because today is Friday, so we have limited times. Maybe we can close this session at 11, yeah, at 11. Before the speaker present her presentation, I would like to read the curriculum vitae of speaker today. Okay, her name is Prof. Datin Dr. Roslina Osman. Okay, Prof. Roslina, the lecturer at Department of Library and Information Science from International Islamic University. And there are many publications that produce by Prof. Roslina. I found more than 150 publications. Journal article and books. Yeah. She also delivered talks on PhD supervision and benchmarking of PhD by research program. I think Prof. Roslina is the proper speaker today because she has expertise on information retrieval, semantic technology, bibliometric, data science, and knowledge management. I think we will start our first session presentation from the speaker. And Prof. Roslina, I will invite you to deliver your presentation for 1 hour or little more. And after that, we have a question and answer session. Okay, the time is yours.
All right. Jazakallah khair, Dr. Agus. And assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh to everyone, what? Especially to our professors, the founder of YRC, and of course, director whom I met before, and then the dean, and of course, Ibu as the head of the department or the program. And not forgetting also, I look forward to also welcome the participants. So I hope at the end of the session, I'll be able to inspire the young ones, to fill in the gap and also to come up with new things, okay, not just extending on what we have contributed and done, okay, but also something that they initiate, okay, something that they have pioneered, okay. So first of all, I would like to introduce my research unit first, okay, and then I will start with the materials. Okay, so just a minute, let me get it, still not this one, I guess. Yeah, okay. All right, so this is the research cluster or our research unit, okay. And this currently, we put our focus, okay, on the WISEmatic search engine. What does it mean? It means that it is a wisdom and semantic based, okay, search engine for reliable content. Okay, so the vision and the mission is that we are coming up, okay, with the semantic models. Okay, at the same time, we are pioneering, yeah, on the wisdom models, okay, for capturing and representing the body of knowledge in the niche areas of the university. Okay, there are many international Islamic universities in the world now, and in fact, we have UIN and also some universities in Indonesia. So somehow, this is relevant. Okay, this is relevant to many of us. Okay, and also we also presented our search engine, the idea, okay, before we conduct the project to the European Union for the EU grant, and these are actually a sample for them to see. So our university, of course, is Rahmatan Lil Alamin, and I saw the video, okay, about YRC just now. So it's very impressive because YRC is really moving forward, yeah, with the community, the society, and of course, giving examples, okay, of works, okay, in Indonesia himself, okay. So really, I think we can somehow move on, okay, doing some pioneer work, okay, pioneering works, and also pilot projects if we need some steps, okay, to do it. So these are the members. Okay, we have the expert, almarhum Prof. Dato' Dr. Sidi Fadil, and then Prof. Dato' Dr. Tengku Muhammad Tengku Sembo, and then we have the international Prof. Dr. Muhammad Zaki Khadir, and then we have Dato' Dr. Muhammad Nakhimantar, who has advices on the ontology, yeah, on the semantic technology for the Islamic law. Okay, and currently he's now the minister of religious affairs. And then we also have others, you know, like Prof. Ashraf Hashim, is also a prominent Islamic financial, okay, expert. And then we have Haji Abdul Kudus from the Islamic finance industry, okay. And then of course we have our technologies, okay, Mobis Pro IT and also Pinnacle, previously based in Jeddah, Saudi, and then now it is based in Turkey. So these are our current members under the WISE-MENTIC, but we also have other members, okay, affiliated with the research unit. In fact, we also have Pak Wardi, you know, okay, but because this poster was done in 2022, so inshallah we have a poster for 2023-2024. So these are the awards and the awards that we have received, so that's why I must include my members as well, okay, because they also contributed. And then these are our achievements, okay, and in fact, we have INOPAL Special Award. Thank you to Indonesia, okay, for recognizing our work. And that's why in 2016, we got the Special Award from INOPAL. And just for the WISE-MENTIC search engine, as what Dr. Agus mentioned earlier, okay, it is a search engine. We built it based on the semantic technology. Okay, at the time, there are many already search engine claiming to be semantic based. Okay, so that's why we go for the wisdom based as well. And then we built the ontology from scratch. So we got a grant, several grants. Okay, total up to almost 1 million, not just the WISE-MENTIC, but others that are under the category of the semantic technology represented in the form of an ontology. Because the ontology is a very important tool, okay, and it can come up from library and information science. Okay, that's our area. Okay, because for the technology part, okay, the knowledge technology part, of course, we can take from the technologies, okay, but the content definitely has to be the expertise of people or professionals in library and information science, okay? So that's the introduction of the lab. So now I will go for the materials, yeah? So just give me a few minutes. Okay, so The title, okay, as given to me, is The Power of Semantic Technology, Enhancing Information Discovery and Knowledge Integration. So coming from our university, we offer knowledge integration, okay, models, okay, and we are not going to imitate what our scholars, okay, have done hundreds of years ago, but we are going to put it into a new map, okay, in terms of the space and time, yeah. So really, when I look at the theme, okay, of this particular short course, okay, offered by RC, thank you very much. So I really like the idea of digital transformation and then the interplay between technology, culture, and the role of leadership. So I hope whatever I presented today support the team today. Okay, so actually, when it comes to the challenges of the search engines, okay, we can talk about the search engines from the perspective or point of view of data science, okay? Because recently means early this year or December last year, we have issues of papers, yeah? Issue of journal articles being retracted, okay? That means withdrawn, yeah? Taken out from the journal, okay? And the issue is that mostly, okay, it's about the quality of the journal article. Okay, so to some point, okay, it is transparent, okay, but it's not that transparent. Or it report the true findings, but it is not the whole truth. Okay, it is not 100% true. It could be misinterpretation or incomplete evidences, okay? So there are many reasons, okay? So when we look at the retraction policy, we can connect that to data science, okay? We can connect that to data science. So when there is a retraction policy, the librarian should be aware of this because journal article is also our scope, okay, when it comes to the indexing and extracting services, yeah? So some of them have already gotten a citation, okay? So when it comes to data science, okay, we are encouraging people, okay, to first go for the open science, okay? Open science where everyone is transparent. So if, let's say, the university, okay, or the ministry said that librarians should also be the keeper of the data of a PhD thesis, okay, then we need to be ready with that, okay, because the data, when it is kept in the library or the research center, then it will be reused for a different analysis of perhaps the same objectives. So now where does that data science come? Okay, so after we are involved in the open science, okay, then the data science will come in, where we give an interpretation. Okay, the researchers will consult the librarians, okay, or the information scientists, and then they will give an insight, okay, interpret the data, giving the data a different interpretation, but yet true, okay, beyond the PhD thesis. Okay, this is an example. Or it can also be a grant funded by the ministry or the university, and then they submitted the data to the library or the research unit, and then the information scientist or the librarian will be part of the team to reinterpret the data, use it for a different task, okay, or maybe similar or different objective. Okay, so you need to be thorough, and it's not just one discipline, but it will be many disciplines. Okay, so how does that to do with semantic technology? Okay, is that we need to have, okay, a particular journal article or thesis or newspaper, okay, I mean newspaper produced by internally, okay, a bulletin, etc. So we need to make sure that we can capture the meaning in that article, because once we have that design, there will be several meanings attached to one particular research work, okay? So this is where the new trend, okay, the challenges, okay, of having either a search engine or an internal repository with a feature that can come, that can imitate, okay, the search engine capability and also to do the semantic. So that means search by the meaning, okay? So the semantic representation, okay, knowledge representation by semantic is different, yeah? So for example, like we have the classification scheme, or we have the cataloging tools, okay, those are actually to just say what items exist, okay, and where are they, okay? And then we have the thesaurus, okay, to say, or subject indexing, to say about the content, what's inside that particular journal or thesis or book chapters, okay? Or even video and multimedia items, okay? However, when it comes to the meaning, okay, because there are researchers who will search in our databases, whether our own collection or the one that we subscribe, okay, they will search by the ideas. They no longer search by the keywords, by the subject heading, by the classification scheme, but they will search by the ideas because they want to see, okay, how their ideas at the point of time, okay, have grown, okay, have moved forward, okay, and where is the gap in the idea, and then they would like to explore on that idea. Okay, so people are no longer looking based on the absence and presence of keywords, okay, in an item, but more of the content, and the content itself is more of an idea rather than just a mere information in the article and other types of information sources. Okay, so that's about DataSign. Okay, the current trend is to do DataSign due to its interpretation giving a different meaning. Okay, so therefore the semantic technology, particularly ontology, comes to the picture. Another one is the privacy issues, okay, because we do not want, for example, whenever we research, okay, it's really known, okay, it's really known and tracked, and then people make some sort of analysis or data mining, information mining, or knowledge mining on our search, okay, so therefore we need something that the search engine, okay, is capable to protect, okay, our pattern of searching, especially when it is about ideas. So, for example, many people now saying that whatever they posted, okay, on the Facebook, so it will also appear in other commercial push, okay, information push in the Facebook of others, okay, of our friend. Okay, that's another one. So we need to put our posting, okay, into a proper heading, etc. So that when the other users, okay, or friends, when they come back, then they can see that that topic is under a proper topic, and then that somehow, to some extent, will avoid, okay, misunderstanding and misposting. And then, of course, we need authentic list. Okay, we cannot expect to browse, you know, to browse like 100 items, and then they are meaningless, no meaning at all. Okay, no meaning at all. It's only just saying that there is a paper on this, so you should read. Okay, it's not like that. So we want to have a list that is authentic by Islamic perspective or values or criteria, or our own professional criteria. Okay, it goes with the professionalism. And then we are very ignorant about the doubtful content, because sometimes we are not sure. Okay, so that's why we need to have a proper semantic technology, so that when we search, okay, so we know the value of the content. So that means it gives beyond the title and the abstract, but it also says how it's been done and quoted by others, for example, just like what we have in ResearchGate, okay, and also some softwares or services that inform us that someone has cited us, and then we can also, as an author, check, okay, if our article has been properly cited. Okay, so of course, to some, it's just a mere matching or tracking using or tracing using bibliometric, the chain of citation. But this also can be done under the semantic technology, okay, where we know where our article has been categorized or clustered, and then at the same time where it has been used, okay. And then the semantic technology that we did at our research unit, we call it wisdom-based search engine. So this wisdom criteria, we have embedded it in the filtering process, okay, because for semantic technology, when it comes to search engine, we still have to do the filtering, okay, but the filtering is based on semantic, okay, it's based on the semantic. And then we have the crawling, okay, the indexing, the ranking or the clustering, and then after that, we, in terms of the ranking or displaying the results, okay, we go by the amount of okay, so we promise to give them the reliable content, okay, and of course something that is a 50-50 status, then we say that we cannot commit on that yet, okay, that has to be further endorsed by the expert. And of course, those that are harmful, okay, it depends on the setting chosen by the user, so they can reject or they can still see it appearing, but it will be at the end of the list, okay. So this semantic technology that we did, we used the ontology, okay, and we created it using the OWL editor, okay, Prop2j, okay, and then we also have other tools, okay, so let's say we want to extract the term, okay, the term so that it become the concepts as the entry to the ontology, we use the RStudio, okay, and then for the visualization, we use the Gephi, Gephi software, and then also the Boss Viewer. I think for library, the Boss Viewer will be much easier. And there are many more visualization tools, even those already there in Prop2j. So for the reliable content, our focus, because this is about knowledge integration, okay, so we do with the sense level dictionaries, and then we do it multilingual, so we tested on the corpus, okay, of the first with the Quranic text, Al-Quran, in translation, okay, in Arabic itself, in Arabic, so that means Quranic text, and in translation in Arabic, and then we have Malay, okay, Pimpinan Rahman, and then we have also from China, okay, and then there's another one is English, okay, so we did for languages, okay, of the translation of the Quran, and we do the dictionaries, okay, and the sense level, so we make it to imitate, okay, the ontology. So we found many mismatch, okay, in terms of translation, and in fact, for example, like the one in Chinese script, okay, the translation I can say in Mandarin, it has a long sentence, okay, to describe it, but in Malay and English, okay, it's much shorter, okay, it's like three words, okay, for a particular one word of the Quranic text, okay. So that's why when it comes to the semantic technology, sometimes a sentence is needed, okay, but in the thesaurus and in the classification scheme, it doesn't have to be like one sentence, okay, because when it comes to the semantic, the meaning sometimes cannot be described, or there's no equivalence, okay, in another word when it comes to multilingual. And then our next one, the reliable content, we use the Kitab Kuras, okay, and also some modern words in Islamic finance and banking. The Kitab Kuras, okay, we use Al-Ghazali's work, okay, and then also by Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jalani, okay, and then of course in between we have from sociology, Ibn Khaldun, and also Malik bin Nabi, because this is about integration of knowledge, yeah. And of course all my support is Islamic worldview, because that is what we have in our university and what's functioning. So Dr. Agus mentioned earlier how to go about with the steps, okay? So we call it, okay, we make it a search engine, okay, but actually it's more of a semantic technology, yeah? So it's for chronic information. So anything that is for optimization, okay, will be there on the web. And then we built in the ontology. This is one of them. This is for the Quran, and also Kitab Turas, and also for the Doa and Zikir. And then we offer clustered search results. So it's small, but later on I will show the bigger size, yeah, for you. And then we just go for the ease of interpretation to visualize search results and query expansion. So this one is a sample from the ACTA, the Act, the State Act, four states, yeah, four states in Malaysia, where we produce the ontology, okay, so that's easy for the public to access it. So, for example, the one sample that I showed here, this is small, but we can see the bigger one later on, about marriage, yeah, Islamic marriage, the marriage of Muslim in Malaysia. So, because the Act has also been reviewed, and for potential use and implementation in other countries, for example, like North Africa, yeah, the North African continent. So, as a librarian and so information scientist, we would like to look at it as well and then see if people in other countries can also refer. So, this was done in view of the issue of, you know, the age for marriage and some other issues as well. So, just like Yasi, you know, it's a good trend, and also among the participants to also see what's the need of the public. Okay, it's not just saying what we have in our library, what we have in our subscription, but also to offer, okay, a service to the ummah, okay, or to the society, or even to those SDG goals, yeah, the 17 SDG goals. Okay, so ourselves we categorize our work under SDG 16.10.2, so access to information. And even though we do not want to imitate public libraries, but because we are mostly academic, okay, so we want even the public to understand, okay, more than what they found from Google, okay, so they understand the academic work, okay, but in the form of the for public use, okay, especially those public who really support and participated in reading culture. So this is the one, this is the first phase, okay. So I would like to thank our university, okay, for giving us the trademark, okay, in two classes. Class 9 and class 42 for this one trademark, and also recently have continued, yeah, to sponsor to support financially to maintain the trademark of Wisemantic. So we have two colors actually, this one the rainbow colors and the other one is the purple color. Alright, so these are the first initial connection when we first started. So this is Hukum Baik. And then we have Islamic Finance and Banking, and then Islamic Family Law. But now we have more. So this is the one that we mentioned with the semantic technology. Okay, we clustered them, okay, into two. So this is the one, okay, one. And what we say that it will be somehow either libel or non-committal. Okay, this is another one, all right. And then these are some samples before I move on, okay, so that they explain how does it look like based on the semantic technology tools that we use. This is how it looks like. Okay, the output. So we have here Islamic Finance and Banking. Okay, and then we have here the Islamic Family Law. So this association, okay, or organization, is testing the act the four states in Malaysia in for the North Africa continent. Okay, so this is the ontology that we have built. Okay, so we built this in Portugal. So I must say that Prodigy is the easiest tool, okay, to create an ontology with the semantic base in mind. Okay? So just do the classes, you know, for example here, Putusan Alright, so it's a book, okay? And then the book is actually a compilation of lectures, so we did it this way. Okay? This is the one that is scratch, from scratch, okay? And after that, of course, we can edit them. So the recent version for this project, you don't need to have this underscore anymore. You can just straight away write, okay? And it can be long, okay, or it can be short, okay? But because we decided that it will be used for information discovery or knowledge discovery, and also integration later on with Imam with Al-Ghazali's work, okay? So we decided to keep it as a lecture, because the main purpose at first is for learning. After that, extended to that is under the voice semantic. We reached the second phase, did it as a semantic technology based session team. So these are the description. Yeah? So for example, on being tried and tested, so Allah is not so unjust. Okay, so we improved this one during the period of COVID-19, because we want to make sure that people have access, okay, especially those who we have given the password, okay, simple one, okay, so that they can read and we can somehow reduce, because during the COVID-19 there were issues of mental health, yeah. And then here is Islamic finance and banking ontology. So we go for this one first, under the partnership, okay, under the partnership. So all the conditions, etc. So this come from the sources, okay, used in the Islamic finance industry in Malaysia, and also promoted to other countries who requested, okay, consultancy, under consultancy projects, okay, with our experts. So earlier I mentioned from Ashram, yeah. And then we have the Islamic Family Law Ontology, so that's Dato' Mahathir, the Minister of Religious Affairs. Okay, previously he was the Chief Justice, okay, the Chief Judge, okay, in the Islamic Court, okay. So he gave us the Act of 4 States, okay, so we did this, okay, and then he reviewed it, and then of course also the instances, yeah? So everything in the form of a definition, and also the meaning, and the, where is it in the Act, and how has it been interpreted. So to some extent, it also includes cases like what Dr. Agus mentioned before. So this is one display. It is also there in Portugal. So I advise that participants, if you want to start on this one, you can use a Portugal, and after that you can have it parked, okay, on other software, for example Elasticsearch engine, okay, and then you can run it. Even for the experimentation in the lab to see how it works, you can also use in the Project. So this is the desktop version. Okay, you also have the web version. Yeah? So as long as you register and you're able to log in, so you can do this kind. So this is more on the visualization part. This is the ontograph. Yeah? It is there, so no worry about that. Okay? So it easily can be done. It's just that you need to have the right sources and the right objective. Okay, and then of course some skill of how to select, okay, the concepts. Okay, so there are many approaches. For example, some will take books, okay, the table of content. Okay, so that means if, let's say YRC and partners, okay, have scholastic work, okay, that you like to create an anthology, then you can just take either from the headings or the table of content, or even can have it in an electronic form or digital form, and then run it in any text extraction software. Okay, we do that automatically. You can get the keywords, or you can do that also in other software that can give the word cloud. Okay, so maybe if let's say it's a collection of article approved by the university to be used as a methodology, so you can run in RStudio, RStudio, a building and software, but use the words, the words with the C or the ZIP log, ZIP log, and then click some words from there, and then click add word, and you can have all the items, the instances supporting that word, and then convert that into the project. So that means put it like this. Okay, all right, so this is our menu. So this one is Islamic finance and banking. So this is the portion where we have the partnership, okay, and we also have the hadith and the Quran, okay, and then we also have the book chapter. So this is what we say the integration part. So we connect it, okay. So of course, this visualization in Protégé can switch, can pull to another one. So there are different colors there. So for example, the purple one is coming from the book, and then this color coming from the hadith, okay? And as you can see, this partnership, that particular hadith, profit, okay, is actually having the biggest, I mean, the strongest link, okay? The strongest link. Because we discovered that partnership is always going for profit. So what's the hadith that allow, okay, or how to compute the profit, okay, being shared among the partners, just like what we have in Surah Al-Anfal, you know, the distribution of anima, you know, so that kind. Okay, so here it's the hadith and the partnership as in the book. Okay, so. Okay, so the next one, this one we have done, and we have implemented it at four schools, okay, in Gombak secondary schools, and then this is actually in response, okay, to the case when the director general and also the deputy minister mentioned about the cases of issues, counseling, reading counseling at secondary schools and primary schools. So that's why we did this, okay? And we produced one PhD student, okay? And then she did very well, and she's now a lecturer at one of the universities in Malaysia. So this also has been presented at many places, and we received a very welcoming response, okay, and we hope to implement it further, because we have mentioned it to some people at the Ministry of Education. So this ontology development for Zikir and Doa Al-Maksud at Wisdom level, so we create ontology, and then we park at the Wisdom. So actually, why we did this, okay, because somehow we don't like, right? Even if that particular student is not our child, okay, but see, as a Muslim, we don't like, okay, this label given to this student. So he's cornered, okay, and then the teacher or someone say, you are lazy, you are dumb, you are stupid, you are bad. Okay, because every word that he says is a du'a. And in fact, in the hereafter, and even in this room, we are responsible and accountable for what we express verbally. So that's why we saw the cases reported in the newspaper, so we did this. It's just that he might be a bit naughty, but maybe intelligently naughty, and because we need to finish the syllabus, so the teacher labeled this way or some others, okay? So something that we do not want to see in our Islamic world, because we have everywhere, children who are facing difficulty and having problem, giving problem, but the solution must be Islamic. So therefore, we do the Zikir and Doa Al-Maksud collection first, because in our case, we don't have that. So being a person in library and information science, so we decided to do our own collection, okay, and we compiled it And some of them we tested through the search in Google. And what we found is that there are somehow a doa that is not ma'thur at all. So, for example, a university student, a male, okay, is attracted to a female student, and they recited the doa of so-called coming from Prophet Yusuf alaihi salam, so that Zulaika likes him back. But that is not really true. Okay, so we don't know what's the source of that. So we found that the danger even in selecting the doa. So that's why we decided to do that. So we take from, of course, Hasan al-Banna, and then we also definitely from the Quran and the Hadith, and also the compilation of Imam Nawawi. Yeah? So we dispersed in many sources from the web. So therefore, we felt that we need to do that semantically using Proto-J just now, the tool that at that time we were having an experience. Okay, so we did the translated text as well in Malay, because it's for the use in Malaysian school, yeah, by the counselors. So the counselors already give their preparation. Thank you very much. And then it is organized under many headings. Some are too specific, some are really very broad. Okay, so we also got feedback from members, friends, okay, from Saudi Arabia, saying that sometimes, you know, when we don't have issues to make doa, and the doa can be general. So what we want, it is searched by the problems and the goals. So when we submitted the system for use by the counselor, the ontology, the, using the semantic technology, okay, in the Proto-J, and of course the visualization, the counselor submitted the doa to those students who came to see them. And then the student, of course, they can choose. And, you know, they will choose, of course, the shortest one, all right? So that's why we give the doa in several range. So shortest to longest, okay? And in fact, we give also the guide of how to shorten the long doa, okay? And then we have the expert who endorsed our process, okay, and who starts, okay, and he's the one who said that the doa should be into stream, okay. One is asking for success, okay, the other one is a protection, okay. So these are the doa. So we have the Quran on this side, and then we have the hadith on this side. So for example here, sejukkanlah hatiku, you know, and so on. So please bear in mind, this is the case of for this primary and secondary school for the counselor, yeah, to use it for their members. So this is again the semantic tool that we use, the ontology built in Proto-J. Okay, but of course after that, once we are clear, done, everything is valid in terms of inferences, so we upload it in our semantic search engine. So I'm sorry because some of the vocabulary might not be comfortable to some, but these are being built from the counselor. So the counselor give the cases, and then from the case, we build the ontology. Okay, so you might see some of the words that are quite, you know, maybe make us very uncomfortable. So we focus on this one, cubaan, you know, diri. And then these are the selected doa, okay. So agar diberi ketenangan hati, agar dikurniakan keampunan, hidayah rezeki. Okay, at that time, we need to put the space, the underscore. But now, we don't have to. Okay, it's more flexible and friendlier than before. So dimudahkan urusan, and then buat mengubat perasaan duka or stress, yeah. Alright, so this is the result when we do the cubaan bunuh diri. So these are the ontology. So we give this, and when the counselor search, okay, or by clicking or by keying in, okay, the words, okay, I don't think I missed that slide, okay. They can enter also, and then when they click, so they can see some doa here. So they will click, and then they will get the doa, and then they will give to the pupils, okay, who came to see them. Okay, so now on our side, because we are academic, So often we have to report on the result. Yeah, we have to report. So we have to say we interviewed the counselor and also counselor who just got the result but did not use the system. So they say that yes, it is important, not important. So most of them say it is important. Okay, because they can give an alternative in terms of the spiritual side, the religious side, and then it does make a difference. So alhamdulillah, those who got the doa, they came back and they are able to cope, yeah, to cope with life. But of course they need time. Some need like 1 week, but most need like 1 month, 2 months. And after that, we also have cases that need about 5 to 6 months. Okay. So when it comes to the system performance, it is precision 91%. So meaning that whenever the counselor search, okay, they got within 9, okay, to 10 out of 10 results. Yeah, so that means it's all relevant. So this is what I will hope. Of course, they don't necessarily wear the kutiyah or anything, but this is just one example. Okay, so therefore their life in studying, especially full of doa. So for example, worshipping Allah only, okay, for example, when they visit the ummah, whenever they got stuck in education, so instead of having stress or going for, you know, drug sold on the street, so they will just read or visit me. So all these doa. So we will also ask to do a similar one for the non-Muslim. So we are trying to get some funding, hopefully there is, okay. So maybe we need to involve psychology, yeah? Psychologists, child psychologists, to give them some inspiring cases, etc. So these are actually just some conclusion that we need. The next one, as I mentioned earlier, is Malik bin Nabi, okay. This is actually when the university like to go for pattern, yeah, patenting the work. So we do not want to do something that we could label Islamic, but actually it is just an Arabic word or Malay word, or we thought Islamic word, actually labeling the conventional one. So we want to avoid that, because when we look deeper, it's not actually an innovation, it's just a different name given to something already existed. Yeah, so we use a method, Tricks method, which is famous in engineering. So it's good if we can also include people from the engineering library, okay, or engineering librarian, and to help us to do a domain, okay, particular domain. So in this case, just the model, okay, so we have the model here, using the Tricks method coming from engineering. And then after that, we discovered this, we use Gephi, yeah, we use Gephi software, again, easy, but we need to have the system librarian, yeah, to assist us. So we did the cluster, and when we see that, we realized that the most famous expert in Islamic finance and banking is Abbas Mirafor. Okay, he's the one who has led the cluster, okay, into venture, into innovations in Islamic finance, okay. And our equation is from Malik bin Nabi. And Malik bin Nabi is famous for many decades now, okay, especially among people in the Muslim world and also the Western world, even in Malaysia, even till today, Malik bin Nabi has been discussed. Okay, so this is the one parameter, because it's engineering, so it's a bit of many graphics, yeah, many graph diagram that we need to do. Okay, this come from the Malik bin Nabi thoughts on civilization. Okay, and unfortunately, to come up with innovation, our society to come up with innovation, we don't have the means, yeah, to do that. So we had to rely on whatever being sent to us or being offered to us from a different world. Okay, from people also always say from the Western world. But actually, as long as it can assist us, so in my opinion, we can use it. But of course, we need to have partners, okay, from the technology side to design it, okay, specially for us, like what we did for our Wasmantic search engine. But this one, we use the first the technology for the extraction, and so for the breaking the sentences, okay? And then after that, we have designed our own. We call it the SAO exception. Yeah? So we come up with our own design. So still under the semantic technology. So this is just an example. So you can see here the clusters. Okay, so the materials, okay, that we can use to be placed in our collection, and after that we can come up with the ontology. So based on this GAFI program, we found that, okay, in Malaysia, it is a more of a commercial, yeah, product, the product. So that's why at banks we have counter, and we also have the product or services, okay. But in the South Asia, like Pakistan, the Islamic finance is more of a social welfare, okay, social well-being. Both countries have both, but in Malaysia, focus more on the commercial aspect because it's a transaction, you know, banking transaction. But in the Pakistan, it's more of a social welfare. Okay, another one is the makam-based. This is another way of developing the semantic technology, preparing the structure. Okay, so we have taken from Al-Ghazali, okay, Minhajul Abidin. So when you hear about Minhajul Abidin, you always talk about Sufism, etc. But we can also do the IT part, okay, as a preparation for the semantic technology. So we do the 7 triggers. Okay, so it's not like the game, yeah, tangga dan ular or snake and ladder. No, it's not. Okay, so we took his book, instead of flat, horizontal, we take it vertical. Okay, so that means it's a climbing. Okay, so therefore we go for the state one. This is the finite state machine, yeah, coming from the computer science or IT. So that's the diagram. This is the makams. From Al-Ghazali, okay, we got copyright on this one, and then we do the triggers and transitions. This totally from Al-Ghazali's book, okay, Minhajul Abidin, and then we do all this, okay, and we have the psychologist and the sociologist to validate it, and after that we put it in the semantic technology-based learning, okay, personal learning, and of course because of the privacy issues, we never record their transaction. It's only a questionnaire they have to complete. Okay. So we have the self-assessed questions, as I mentioned before, and then we have semantic-based attribute. So this is the semantic-based attribute. Okay. And then the positive-negative attributes, and then we do a map on the state transition. Okay. And then for the as a trial for IDB, based on the sources from IDB, the Islamic Development Bank, so they are going for the climate finance. So this is what we are looking now, okay? Because the microfinance is very important, especially countries that are recovering from economics issues. Okay, so this is the scope. So this is another way of how to develop the ontology for the semantic web or semantic technology. In our case, this is for the web semantic. So the definition, how it was at IDB, so we got this data already. So now the next phase is to do the semantic harmonization. So this is the problem because, for example, in just to give you something that we know every day, we have two types of courts. Okay, one is the conventional court, civil court, and the other one is the Islamic court, you know. Mahkamah Syariah, okay, Syariah Court. So sometimes we need to harmonize some of the rulings or some of the decisions, okay, because people can just go one court to get an advantage, okay. So therefore, there should be somehow a harmonization. So the harmonization will not be decided by us, the librarian and information scientist, but decided by the right panel, yeah. So that's all. Thank you very much, Dr. Agus.
Very, very interesting topic, but honestly, personally, it's not easy.
I think Dr. Agus, you need to unmute.
Okay. It's okay?
Yes, yeah, okay.
Okay,
now.
Okay. Yes. Okay, it's very interesting topic, but honestly, personally, it's not easy to understand and the semantic web and its application in discovering information and as well as to integrate the knowledge and or knowledge integration, but I think it's a great project that for example for Islamic University should do, yeah, because I find that in semantic web we can control for example for the project from Prof. Roslina, there is Amar Ma'ruf Nahi Munkar. Amar Ma'ruf, so we have a control by ontology, yeah. But before I offer to participant to us, I would like Prof. Roslina to maybe you can demonstrate why semantic, how why semantic runs, yeah, and what is different between similar search engine, maybe it's possible,
okay.
Prof.
Yeah, actually because our server, okay. Is only for internal use.
Okay.
So I cannot, yeah, but maybe in the future I can prepare that because we want to secure it. It has been previously it has been hacked twice, but because of we have a backup, so therefore we are able to have it up again. It was attacked twice in 2017, yeah. And that's why we right now, because we need also to protect the content at the university, so we don't have it for outside access. So that's why I cannot demo it. But I can tell how it works. Okay, as I mentioned earlier, you have a protege, okay, in the website, okay, so you can go there, okay, and there is the web base, okay, so let me try to see if I have, okay, so in the meantime, okay, so this particular protege, okay, will assist you on how to do that, yeah, so let me, okay, it is called the guide, okay, so okay, so this is the somehow the guide, okay, okay, so this is the one that I mentioned, so there's also the screen cast, okay, 15 minutes, okay, and when you read this, of course, it is a bit difficult, it might seem, it looks like it require so much of technology skill, okay, technical skill, but actually it is very friendly, okay, so this is just the technical side of it, okay, but when it comes to this one, okay, so actually you can just go to this page, okay, after you have installed it, okay, so let me, I need the username, okay, I will do that later, so you just click here, and then after that it says create, and then you just create it, okay, so for example in my case I will just create our thing here, right click, and then it will come up create, okay, and then after that you create your first ontology, okay. So, for example, like the one that we did a few weeks ago is about simple syrup. Okay, so simple syrup. So, because we want to somehow make sure that the public will be able to learn about Sirah Nabi, okay, in a very simple sense. Okay, so we use one book. It is for the foreword is by Mufti Man. Yeah. So and then after that, if you click again here, the one that says Simple Sirah, you click and create, and then you will do another class under another ontology. Okay, so for example, let's say the blessing. Okay, so that means the birth of the prophet, the blessing, for example. And then after that, you can create a sibling, saudara mara, yeah, of the concept. Okay, the concept of blessing. Okay, so you can have semua. Okay, or you can create. So that means this is how the structure look like. Okay, the structure look like. So first, you need to prepare the concepts. Okay, the concept can be prepared in many ways, as I've shown earlier. Maybe by the table of contents, okay, of selected books, or together the whole thing, okay, you put it in the R studio, okay, R studio, and then after that, you can have the words, yeah. So R studio here is actually for bibliometrics, okay, what we call. Yeah, I search for you to show the R studio, and it is a Biblio Shiny. I think in Indonesia this is one of it. Okay, because you can see the Google search now. Okay, this is the one. Okay, so you can have access to it. Okay, and then you can see that over here. Okay, take the one that can produce you the words. Okay, so for example, documents here. And then you run it in Zipflow. It's automatic. It's very easy. Okay, doesn't need to have a special skill. Okay, so you can go and then you can find that there are clouds. Okay, word cloud, and then you can take the words from there and then put it here. Okay, so you can put it here. Okay, the concepts. Okay, but if you already have the concepts, then you can skip the one in the Google Shiny. Okay, so after that, okay, you can go to the Protégé, do it like this, and then you can do the definition here. Okay, this sounds like more of a medical or biology, so but you will have your definition here. Okay, as I said earlier, it can be three words, so it can be a sentence, long sentence, like this, okay? So here, this is the semantic relationship. The semantic relationship is the most important one, okay? For example, if let's say we have a class, okay, I'm just giving you an example, a class. So let's say the course code is, let's say, 1901, for example. So we say, okay, the name of the lecturer. So let's say Dr. A has class 1901. Okay, so we give relationship. So that means that class 1901 is related to this lecturer Dr. A. Okay, so this is what we meant. Okay, so in our case, we say has mazhab. Okay, has mazhab, has doa. So for example, cubaan bunuh diri here. Okay, here, cubaan bunuh diri has doa. And then the doa. Okay, that's doa and doa. So either you can have the whole doa, the whole sentence, or you can just take this one from that concept again. Okay, so because for the doa, we have two parts. Here is the doa, and then we have the perlindungan, and then we have the permohonan. So we connect them. So that means cubaan bunuh diri is the case, and then we have the perlindungan, and then we also have the permohonan. So we have three here. Has the case, and then has the doa perlindungan and doa permohonan. Okay, so this is very easily done. Okay, provided that the librarian or the person who designed it must know where is it. Okay, where to put it. So this guy, okay, is really helping, especially the one on the web. Okay, this is from the web. So next, you can have also collaboration support. Yeah, this is what the one that we use as well. So that means we share. There's a feature there to share. And then you can have many people to Eddie. Okay, so you can see people are adding it. Okay, people are adding it. And then you have here also, okay, this is the description. Okay, so this is the RDFS. Okay, so this is the details. Okay, so in fact, we know already who has entered it, and this is just to go back to the responsible person if there is any issues or anything problem. So you can still add comment, okay, and then this comment can also be used to search, to do filtering later on. Okay, so these are just the record keeping of who has entered and what else can be searched in addition to the concept that we created, because the concept that we created might go for recall as many relevant items, but this part will do the precise one, okay, to make sure that, for example, the one that the counselors have done, okay, they got 9 to 10 over 10, okay. So these are all just the viewing, the technical part, okay, and then this is the structure when you want to see in this format, okay. So, for example, this part, okay, it has, for example, here has a whole namespace and all those instances, okay, so that's the feature instances in the protege, okay. And then this is how it negatively regulates. For example, you want to avoid, okay, or reject some of the items. Okay, so these are just... okay, and then you also have a subclass, so you can have more relationship, has height, has length. So in our case, has Quran, has hadith, has doa, and then has kutubul ghaib, has the Islamic law, has the Islamic finance, has the Islamic banking, and then also has the financial industry. Okay, so we have that. So once we have the have or the has, then we have to reverse it. So is out. Okay, so for example, Dr. A has class, Dr. A has course 1901. 1901 is a course of Dr. A. So it's like that. It has to be reversed. Okay, so first it has, and then is off. Okay, so that means it's not just one relationship, but it has to be a written relationship. Okay, and then all these are just the imports. Okay, if you want to import, there's a feature of importing. And actually, if we make errors, Protege will tell us there's error, and then they will assist us to correct it. So this one is the rules. Okay, so you can have rules. So for rule, for example, so we have this kind of thing. This one look technical, but actually, when you key in the cell, okay, it will come out like this. Okay, it will come out like this. So this is just a matter of the interface. Okay, so that's another one. Okay, so for example, just ignore this part. Okay, so when it comes to search, you say that the rule is for rejection is Boolean not. Okay, this is very familiar by the library. Yeah? Alright, so that is the basic one. Okay, so while waiting for maybe I can while waiting for me to show the real look of the Protege, maybe I'll take some questions.
Okay, thank you, Prof. I think the Department of Library of Information Science in ERC has homework to invite you come to ERC and we can discuss more about the implementation of semantic web for discovery, information discovery. Okay, we have approximately a half hours to participant, yeah, to ask something to you. Okay, participant, are you with us? Okay, we have a participant from Okay, from Aryo Adi Prakoso. Okay.
Mr.
Aryo? May you hear? Okay. Okay, please.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Halo, Alhamdulillah. Thanks for your presentation. It's very good. But I can ask for you. In Indonesia, there are still few digital libraries because the semantic technology skills of librarians are still low. So, how to introduce semantic technology in traditional libraries? Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. Yes. Actually, when it comes to semantic technology, we don't really say that this technology already digital library or this library is a traditional, okay? Because it goes with it goes with equal, equal footing. So your question is about the traditional library. So I assume that it is very little digital, right? Digital in the library. So this is also the case that we have, even though we have digital library, but the collection for the some item, okay, I don't want to mention which one, okay. So some collections, they are totally hard copy, So we don't have the digital, the digital one. So that's why, it's a very good question from you, I must say. I missed that as well. So we need to scan the pages, because we couldn't find the item on the web as well. Not even in the scanned images. You know, scanned images where the author uploaded not digital born, but they scan it in terms of graphics, So, even that also is not there in Google, okay? In any other, digital library or search engine or even in the repository. So it is there sitting, sitting, collecting dust in the place there, at the corner there. So we took those things, okay, we clean up because of the dust. So we had to do digitization first, okay? So in order to get budget, so we need to do on a sample. This is reality, on a sample. And then we transport the items, we bring it to the lab, and we clean it up first, okay? Clean it up, because we need to do the digitization or digitalization. Okay, so we are given the machine, a big machine, scanner, okay? And also we were given a software, and then we hire okay, to do the scanning. So, but first we finish the cleaning process from the dust or anything marks, okay, any marks from the from the papers, okay, and then we put it under the scanner, and then we are able to do it. Actually, we requested to use it to use a better machine where we don't have to do half automatic, half manual. Okay, so once we done, we produce two versions. One is the Microsoft Word doc file, and then the other one is the PDF file, which is readable. Okay. So we did that, okay, and then we run into the software to make sure that because the items are in English, so we do the spelling check, okay, spelling check, because we cannot afford to pay someone to read it and to correct all the spelling errors. For example, like instead of A, it becomes E, so this is how we did it. So we did it by the machine. We're not going to have anyone to read the whole text, So after that, we compile it, okay, we compile it, and then we do the analysis. So we did it in the R studio. We get all the words, and then we use word step 7 and QBA minor. These are softwares that are easily managed by a librarian. There's no need for a certain high level skill. It's just a basic skill, know how to use the system, basic. And then after that, we got the themes, we got the words, the word cloud, and then in the word set, the one that uses word set 7, the word set 7 will give us even the value of the words. Okay, so from there, we bring it to Plot2J, and then put all the one that are shown earlier, okay, and then from there, under the Plot2J, there's also the graphics, okay, the visualization. So from the visualization that we have, they will tell the strength, and then we also compare that in the VOS viewer to see the relationship. So after that, we do the semantic relationship. So for example, let's say Islamic finance. The Islamic finance has what? What is of Islamic finance? Okay. So for example, non-interest or La Riba Bank, for example. So we did like that. So in our case, we did two. Academic and industry, okay, because that was the requirement or the demand for it. After the Plot2J, we use the Elasticsearch, okay, the Elasticsearch engine. So this is where we use all the tools, okay, in the Elasticsearch engine, which is quite easy. We call it Lucene, okay, and then we run. But this one really go for the higher level of technology, okay. So for us, we develop by ourselves, okay? We have programmers and they develop it, okay? So we have the alternative in the Elastic search engine, okay, Lucene, and then we also use our own, okay? Because we need to have a backup, right? And then for our own, okay, we tested it first in Plot2J query, okay? The query in Plot2J, where we do all the commands, which is a template base, solely there given by Plot2J. After it has run, it shows that there is no error, okay, because if there is error, Plot2J will reject your submission. Yeah? So after that, you bring upload it on the Elasticsearch, which is Lucene technology, and then you can also do it on your own design or program. Semantic search, okay. So then it will stop there. After that, because of the access, okay, because it requires a certain speed, so you need to have a server, a strong server. One, of course, in our case, it is inside. And earlier, when we want to do the evaluation by 200 plus users, we park it at the ministry, okay, and we need the ministry to help us to control and to protect the data. So definitely we need the government support. So we have four servers there and they handle it for us. But when the contract or the agreement has completed, so now it is parked at our university for the next stage. So we are now in the third stage of development. I hope that can be understood, I hope. Sorry, I cannot hear clearly, so
yeah, because he's in trying, right? Going back to
yeah, sorry, I can't hear.
It's noisy.
I think echo, okay. Or something. So.
Okay, any other participant want to ask? Hello? Not yet? Okay, Prof. We know that recently, some library develop, rather than using library catalog, they also develop like discovery tool, like implementing Foofine It's also the implementation of semantic web for discovery tools.
Okay, for the discovery tools.
Yeah, like for find, like.
It's not necessarily semantic because what goes with the semantic is the relationship. Yeah, oh. It's the relationship. So it's not just. It's a relationship that we can map, and then there's a value in that map. Okay, so if let's say it's just the information discovery is only for, it's only based on keywords, and the keywords are just like a thesaurus. Okay, common. Okay, so that means several system, they share the same thesaurus. And then they do the one search information discovery. That is not semantic technology. Yeah, semantic technology minimum is an ontology. It's an ontology. So, if let's say the library, do the taxonomy, so that is close to a semantic because taxonomy is higher than indexing. Yeah, it's higher than index. Because taxonomy has more details, so has more details and show what is the relationship. So for example, like for marine biology, for example, we have the red sea, yeah, the red sea. So we know that when we have the red algae, you know, the poisoning algae of a certain season. So first, of course, we need to catalog it. Okay, to put all the details and of course all the metadata there, and then after that from there we need to mesh it with the taxonomy. That's a minimum, but then if that taxonomy can be converted into ontology, giving a relationship. Okay, for example, like this red algae, poisonous algae, is poisonous, can cause the Red Sea after it has come in certain numbers. Okay, so therefore you can say red algae has numbers, and then you can say that number has poisoning effect. Okay, so there are several relationship there. So if you can see earlier in the sample, the has many. Okay, has algae, has color, has certain measure. Okay, so therefore that is what we call semantic. But if it's just based on the thesaurus, okay, in terms of absence or presence in the records, okay, then it is only, it's not a semantic by category or by definition. It's just information discovery based on the traditional or on the normal index, okay, on the normal representation, semantic representation. Or knowledge representation definitely must have relationship. As simple as David likes chocolate. Chocolate is a dessert for David. Yeah, like that. Yeah. Okay, and then they can have more sweet dessert, or you know, or spicy, entry. Okay, so they are many. So the more we describe the favorites of David, so the more we know about David. Yeah. So this is what it meant, but. If the information discovery just the normal repository, then it is not. Yeah, I'm sorry. So, yeah.
Okay, Prof. There's question from Anissa Putri Yasmin in Zoom chat, Prof. How can semantic technology be used in practical applications such as knowledge management system or information retrieval? And how can semantic technology help discover hidden relationships, pattern in complex data?
Okay, for the first part, semantic technology used in practical applications, the one that I've shown earlier for the use by counselors, yeah, for the use for counselors, so they can just have the option because they are end users who are not really having high literacy in technology, so we let them just click, okay, and also they can search in the WiseMatic search engine, but of course there are certain procedure that they have to fulfill because we need to protect, okay, the data privacy, etc. And also the whole data that we have done for many years, yeah. So that is the practical part of it. Okay, being used by counselors to give the doa, etc. So right now the challenges is to add more doa and to make the doa much clearer. Okay, for selection by the counselors, because right now still some information is not really complete. Okay, not much. Okay. Even though it qualify the ontology or semantic relationship, but it's not much details, further details. So that's why we also need to add in some experts, yeah. For example, things like Budi, there are too many categories now, okay, so we need to come up with that. Okay, so that's the next stage, but I don't know when we can start. And then the knowledge management systems, okay, just like the counselor just now, it is case by case. So if you are referring, okay, to knowledge management system in the form of implicit knowledge or tacit knowledge, so we need to have the cases, yeah, case by case. So for example, you can have, let's say in human resource division, you can have the secular, okay, you can start with the secular because that's the one that is not confidential to a certain level, yeah, but because the real cases, the real meeting minutes, okay, are very confidential, okay, and there are lots of signing, okay, for privacy and confidentiality that we need to complete. So the best is to go through the circulation, yeah, circular letter. And then you can take either the heading, the subject line of the letter, okay, of the circular letter, and then you will just say that circular has and which meeting. Okay, which meeting. So definitely some circular will have more than one meetings, okay, because the enforcement, etc. will be there. So for example, the circular is for, let's say, sabbatical leave, for example, okay. So sabbatical leave, so there are many meetings. So if let's say just the minimum meeting for approval of sabbatical might take, you know, let's say every month. So that means it's 12 or 10 to 12 minutes. Okay, so you need to have that. Or if you're referring to the knowledge management in terms of capturing the academic, yeah, academic, that means the what is delivered in the curriculum, okay, in the course outline. Okay, so therefore you need to have the course outline, the name of the course outline has lecture. So lecture 1, lecture 2, lecture 3, lecture 4. Okay, so you need to have all the descriptions about the lectures, so that if, let's say, the head of department or the higher authority or the accreditor of the program, they can search and then they will find. Okay, so that particular course have, let's say, 80% of hands-on, yeah, because we also included the course plan, yeah, the course plan of the particular course. Okay, so if that is what you meant in the academic, that's also under the knowledge management. For information retrieval, as I mentioned earlier, it is the idea, because now people don't search anymore by the keywords, because if you use the keywords, you can try this one. Even in Scopus, sometimes when we try the keywords that we use will retrieve the old set, the results from 1970s, 1980s, 1990s, because the birth of that idea happened in the 1970s, for example. And then it has grown, okay? It has grown, and either you can check the latest keywords through the lateral search, or, okay, it's best that you search it by the idea. So the idea can only be found in ontology. It cannot be found in the thesaurus, because thesaurus is only describing. Okay, of course, better than the classification scheme. So that's why you can see when you search in Scopus, and even Scopus is better than Emerald. When you search in IEEE Explore, it is better than ACM Digital Library, even though both are digital libraries. And when you search in the medical databases, they are better than other databases. And then because the medical databases even have the court case, yeah. And then you can also, when you search in Embase, it is better than Medline, okay? Because they use Thesaurus and the others, they use classification scheme. But now we are moving to search by the idea, and normally idea is a concept. And that can be successfully done through the semantic technology. So for example, let's say the idea is to come up, okay, with the technology, okay, or possibilities, okay, of digitalization, okay. So we come up with an idea, okay, of how that product will be, okay. So when you go to the ontology, it has, you know, has idea, has product, okay. So you can search there. But if you search in the normal retrieval system, the indexing and abstracting service, you might not be getting it. Unless you work really hard, okay, to target for the state of the art review, okay. So this is, the time will be shortened. Okay, will be shorter when you create your own ontology, or you borrowed the ontology from another association or another organization. And then, how can semantic technology help discover hidden relationships? This one, you need AI. Definitely you need AI. So now we have what we call the AI-powered analytic. Okay, power. And I'm not referring to ChatGPT or Bard Gemini, no. I'm referring to the AI-powered analytic. Okay, so in Malaysia, we have about two companies, two vendors who can do that. We can also contact the expert or the companies in India. And I think, I'm not sure about Indonesia, maybe they are also vendors or suppliers, yeah, or providers of these AI-powered analytics. So this is the one that can help on the semantic technology to discover hidden relationships. It cannot be done by other than the AI. So I hope I answered that. Yeah. This is under data science, the last one.
Yeah. Okay, thank you, Prof. We have 5 minutes again. Any question? No? Okay, if there is no question, I would not to conclude, but I think the important thing today is LIS department at our university, Yaris University, I think has homework to invite Prof. Roslina to come to Jakarta, and we can discuss more about the implementation of web semantic, yeah, and we can learn more, yeah. Okay, before ending this session, I would like to thank to Prof. Roslina, and we will give applause to Prof. Roslina for this session. Okay, thank you, Prof. Roslina, for joining to this course. I hope the next we will meet again in virtual or physical meeting in our department. Thank you, and we say alhamdulillah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you, Professor Roslina, for sharing your insightful knowledge by the course session. And thank you for Mr. Agus Rifai for leading our main agenda this morning. Before we taking a break session, we must have a pause session for. So for all audience, please set your camera on. for the first slide. 1, 2, 3. The second slide. 1, 2, 3. The third slide. 1, 2, 3. The next slide. 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
Thank you for all of your attention. And kindly access the materials and other activities on Layar ERC through your respective accounts, which have been sent by the committee via email. We also remind you to fill the attendance link via Google Form that will be sent in Zoom chat. Once again, we kindly remind you to fill the attendance link via Google Form that will be sent in Zoom chat. For all of the participants, please remain to stay on the Zoom as there will be announcement from the academic course team regarding several matters about academic completion. So for the academic course team, the time is yours.
Is my sound okay? Is it clearly?
Please unmute, Mr. Dana.
Okay. Is it clear?
Okay, clear. Okay, clear.
Alright, thank you. Thank you, Baik and Keiza. Hello, everyone. I want to explain and give announcement. I will share the file first. So, there are several there are announcements. The first is about certificates, and then due dates, and the last about asynchronous activities via layar. The first, about the certificates. There are two certificates. Two kind of certificates. The first is certificate of attendance, and the second is a certificate of completion. Certificate of attendance available for you. Each session or each topics, there are 6 certificates, and we will provide to you based on attendance list via Google Form. And the certificate of completion, it's only one certificate available after you do all learning activities and finish the final exam via layar. And then after that, we need to announce that the due date of all activities are on Wednesday, March 20, 2024 at 11 p.m. in Jakarta or UTC plus 7. And the last about how to use layar or ERC learning management system, please just go to the web browser and enter the URL layar.erc.ac.id, and then you can log in, use ID and password sent to your email by committee. Please check your inbox or spam, maybe the email is there, and then You can, after login, you can click the digital transformation course, or you can click the link below. And you need to agree the course unit contract first and do all activities and meet assessment methods and criteria. For the assignment is available in topic one or first step topic about SLIMS, and then observation. We will see the activity completion in layar Yasi, and the quiz are the quizzes are available for every topics. There are six quizzes, and the last final exam is available in the last session of layar. So you need to meet the assessment methods and criteria before 20 of March. And after that, the committee will send you the certificates via email. So it's all the announcements. Thank you. And back to Baik and Geza. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you for the excellent delivery, Mr. Danang Duijo.
Now, we finally reached the final agenda of today's event and also the last day of International Short Course 2024 series that held by Library and Information Science Study Program of YARSI University. To close the last day of this international short course, let's recite Hamdallah together in this event. We also representing all the committees and every person taking part of this event, if there are any deficiencies and uncomfortable mistakes.
Thank you so much, and may Allah bless you all who follow this event from the first until the last day with the knowledge you have gained from this series of event. And see you in the next exciting and thoughtful event in series. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.